The modulus of a linear function. The modulus of a number is nothing but its absolute value. The absolute value gives us the distance from zero without considering its direction. Suppose if you have the zero over here and this is a negative 5 and this is a positive 5. Then absolute value is nothing but the distance. Here also it is 5 units. And here too it is 5 units. So the absolute value is nothing but the distance from 0 to negative 5 or 0 to 5, both gives us the same unit. Now the modulus of a function is written as f of x equal to mod x. If it is negative 5, then modulus of negative 5 will be positive 5. In the same way, modulus of a 5 will also be 5 only, because it is just the distance. We are not worried about the direction. Now, if x equal to 8, then mod x will be equal to 8. That is, f of 8 equal to 8 only. Now, if x equal to 0, then mod x will also be equal to 0. So, f of 0 is 0. So we know that f of x is equal to x when x is greater than 0. Now let us take a negative number, x equal to minus 8. Then mod x will be equal to modulus of minus 8, which will give us an 8. So mod x equal to 8. So now what do we know now? F of x will be equal to negative x if x is, here it is greater than or equal to, if f is less than 0. So we have the condition that f of x equal to x, if x is greater than or equal to 0, f of x equal to minus x, if x is less than 0. The basic modulus function is y equal to modulus x. So now we know that y equal to mod x, that will be equal to x if x is greater than 0. Y equal to mod x, it will be equal to minus x if x is less than 0. So now let us draw the graph for this. This is the x-axis and the y-axis. Now for all positive x values, that is x greater than or equal to 0, y will be equal to x. So how is our graph for y equal to x? This is the way the graph is for y equal to x. That is, when x is 1, y will also be 1. When x is 2, y will also be equal to 2. So this we are drawing only for the positive values. Now when it is for x take lesser than 0, that means x is negative. When x takes the values negative, y will be equal to minus x. The graph of y equal to minus x is this way. This is the graph of y equal to minus x. That means when x is minus 1, y is positive. When x is minus 2, y is positive 2. Like that it goes on. So now we have drawn the graph of y equal to mod x. Now let us draw the graph of y equal to negative modulus x. So now the same way, when we draw the graph, y will be equal to minus modulus x, that will be equal to minus x when x is greater than or equal to 0. Y will be equal to minus of modulus x will be equal to x when x is less than 0. Because this gives us a negative value is already here, and then we have a negative sign, so we give it as x. So now let us draw the graph for this function. Now, y equal to minus x for all x greater than 0. So here it is the positive. So here we have our graph of y equal to minus x. For the positive x values, we have the graph of y equal to minus x. For the negative x values, we have the graph of y equal to x. Y equal to x only for this negative values. We are drawing the graph, so it is like this. So this is the graph of y equal to minus x. And also we can see the relation by transformations. That is, when it is y equal to x and y equal to minus x, when we draw, it will be a reflection in the x-axis. So the graph of y equal to mod x and y equal to negative of mod x, these two will be a reflection of each other along the x-axis. Now let us draw the graph of y equal to modulus of x plus 3. Now this 3 is inside the bracket, that is, it is inside the absolute value. So when it is inside the absolute value, you know, it shifts in the horizontal direction. That is, the graph moves towards the left 3 units. Now let us draw the graph. So now when we have it, it is just 1, 2 and 3. And here also 1, 2 and a 3. This is the x-axis and this will be the y-axis. So now this moves 3 blocks. So already we know the graph of y equal to mod x is over here. Now it moves 3 blocks to the left. So 1, 2, 3. So our graph will be like this. So it will be in the shape of a V. Now in the same way, suppose if we have a graph of y equal to modulus x minus 3. This means the graph moves 3 units to the right. So our graph moves like. X and y. So if it is a 3 over here, so 1, 2 and a 3 blocks it moves, because it moves to the right. So we have our graph in this way. And now suppose if our graph is y will be equal to minus of mod x plus 3. The same thing. We just reflect it in the x axis. This is y and this is an x. So now here a 3 over here. So we reflect it downward like this. Negative of it, we reflect it down the same way. Now y will be equal to minus of modulus x minus 3. The same way, this graph we reflect it below the x-axis. And this is a 3, so we reflect it below. From this we see that the graphs are always V-shaped curves. When the graph has a positive sign, that is, when the absolute value function has a positive sign, the graph will open upward. If the graph has a negative sign before the absolute value, then the graph will open downwards. And also we see that here the value for it is a 1. So now when we take this, 1 will be called as a slope. This 1 is a slope. That is, when you have x value, the y value will also be 1. The x value 2, y value will also be 2 from these points. For the next graph, that is y equal to mod x plus 3. That is, now when we take, our graph is moving only upward 3 blocks. This is outside the absolute value, so it moves upward 3 blocks. So how do we have our graph? And then, now when we move it upward, this is 1, 2 and a 3. This is 3. So now our graph, the slope over here, this is the 1 which is in front, that is the slope, m. M will be equal to 1. That means y over x is the slope. So y is also 1, x is also 1. So from this, if you want to make more accurate your graphs, you can just move 1 unit over here in the x direction, 1 unit in the y direction. So you get your point. Then again, 1 unit over here, 1 unit over here. The same way here, 1 unit and 1 unit. Again, 1 unit and 1 unit. So we have it over here. This will be the shape of a graph. Suppose if there is a negative sign in front of it, the same thing, we just draw it reverse over here on this y-axis, the negative y-axis. Now, suppose if you have your graph like this, y will be equal to x minus 3 plus 2. The absolute value of x minus 3 plus 2. That means this is a negative 3. So automatically what you know, it moves towards the right 3 blocks, and its outside it is a 2. So it moves upwards 2 blocks. Now we draw this graph. In order to draw this graph from here, this is the center 0, 0. So now this has to move 3 blocks to the right. So 1, 2, 3. 3 blocks to the right and 1, 2. So this will be the point over here. And then the slope is 1. So from here what you do, since a slope is 1, the x value is also 1, the y value is also 1. The point moves over here. Again, x is 1, y is also 1 here. Again, from this, x is 1, y is 1 over here. X is 1, y is also 1. So over here. So we just draw our graph with those points. This is our graph. Now this end point is called the vertex of the graph. Vertex. Now if we can fix our vertex, then it is easier for us to draw the graph. So now first let us find out how to fix this vertex. In order to fix this vertex, what we do is, we just equate our modulus function to 0. So what is our modulus function? X minus 3 equal to 0. So we get it as x equal to 3. Now substitute this value of x as 3 in our function. So y will be equal to 3 minus 3 plus 2. 3 minus 3 is 0. So we get a value for y equal to 2. So now what is our vertex? The vertex will be equal to 2, 3. This is our vertex. See, this point is, the vertex is 3, 2. X is 3 and y is 2. See, this is 3 and this is 2. The vertex of the graph is 3, 2. I'll write it again. This is the vertex is 3, 2. Let's draw a little more complicated curve. Y will be equal to 2 into x minus 1 plus 3. Now here we have a slope as 2, that is m will be equal to 2. What else do we know? We need to find our vertex. So we can just do it as x minus 1 equal to 0. So x equal to 1. Now substitute it in y. So y will be equal to 2 multiplied by 1 minus 1 plus 3. So this completely is 0 because 1 minus 1 is 0. So y will be equal to 3. So what is our vertex? Vertex is 1, 3. This is our vertex. Now the slope is 2. What is the meaning of the slope 2 is y over x. From the vertex, y has to move 2 blocks and x will move only 1 block. So now we just draw our graph. This is our x and this is our y. Now the vertex for us is 1. I'll just mark it. So 1, 3 is our vertex. 1, 1, 2, 3. So this is our vertex. 1, 3 is our vertex. Now we have to move our graph 2 blocks in the y direction and 1 block in the x direction. So 1 over here and then 2, 1, 2. So this will be our point. Here also it is 1 and 1. So this is our first point. Then again 1, then 1, 2. This will be our next point here, from here. 1 and 1, 2. So when we join our graph, the graph will be in this way. But in case if there was a negative sign, then our graph will be in this direction. Suppose if our graph is y equal to 5 minus 3. Into x minus 2. Now first find the vertex. So x minus 2 equal to 0. So x equal to 2. Substitute this value in y. 5 minus 3 into 2 minus 2. So this gives us a 0 over here. So automatically, so y will be equal to 5. So our vertex is 2 and 5. Now our slope, if you take m, the term with the absolute value is the slope. Our slope is negative 3. That means when it is a negative, you know the curve has to open downward. Now what is it? This will be y over x. y will move 3 blocks and x will move only 1 block. This is the x and this is the y. So now our vertex is 2, 5. 2 and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. 2 and 5 is this point. So this is our vertex. Now our curve has to open downward. So our y is minus 3 and x is 1. So it is 1 and 1, 2, 3. This is our first point. Then the same way, again, this is 1 and 1, 1. 2 and a 3 over here. The same way, x is 1, 1, 1, 2 and a 3 over here. This also 1 and 1, 2 and a 3 over here. This way we draw the using this method, we can sketch the graph of absolute value functions without any difficulty. Thank you.